Saludos, señoras y señores. Mi nombre es Andrew Perez.
Andrew, that's our next video, man.
Oh,
this video is all about how do we translate an application from English to Spanish or other languages also. So welcome guys, and thank you for joining us. I'm here with Andrew Perez. As you can guess, Andrew does speak Spanish, and he'll be kind of showing us how to translate a Canvas application like this one you're seeing on the screen into another language, whether it be English or Spanish, Portuguese, whatever you wish, and a model-driven application like what you're seeing here. So they each have their own different techniques, and they both are gonna start, well, for in our case, we're gonna start with Dataverse first from a model-driven application. Then we'll jump into our Canvas application to show us how do we do more of a manual approach in our Canvas application. So Andrew, the floor is yours. Show us how to translate this thing.
Alrighty, awesome. And to show sort of a practical example of this, we're gonna be using an application that came up in our last Learn with the Nerds.
And this is when we built an application for a Guatemalan charity.
Yes,
and exactly. It was all about tracking students and volunteers and trying to make checking attendance and all of that. So the challenge we had, of course, was the teachers in Guatemala, they don't have to speak English, right?
Right.
So we want to cater that application to their own language.
Exactly. So we're going to be starting right here at make.powerapps.com. And we're just going to come over to our solution that we've built our application in. As we can see, we've got it right here, the Potter's House Treasure System.
Okay. And this solution contains all of our assets for both applications in this
case. All of our assets. All our tables, all our flows, exactly. All together.
Okay.
And then if we come up over to this little gear icon right over here, we can go into the Admin Center.
Ah, so our first step is we have to activate the language.
Yes.
Then we have to go ahead and do the translations after that. So we can start wherever. We're going to go to the Admin Center in this case.
Exactly.
Right?
Okay, gotcha. Microsoft already has some preset translations for us. So what we're going to do is sort of just call one of those into our application. So right now, right here in the Power Platform Admin Center, we're going to go to our environments.
Okay.
And then we're going to find the environment that we've gone ahead and built it in. So I've got it right here as the Potter's House Dev. All right. And then if we go up to this little gear icon that says Settings right here, come to Product, and you'll see one of our options right here is Languages. So this is where we want to go. We're going to click on that. And there is a whole host of different languages that are available to us, a whole lot of them. So obviously for us, we've already gone ahead and selected Spanish. If you want to build an app for people in the Middle East, you can use Arabic, you can use Basque, Bulgarian, Catalan. There's so many different options. All you would have to do is select one and then come down to this little button right here and hit Apply. It typically takes about 10 to 15 minutes to call in. Thankfully, we're not going to make you guys wait that long. We already have this one in our application.
So this is basically installing the core tables that are necessary for that translation. So
Yes. We're
going to show that in a moment here. But if you have things like a contact table, an account table, those tables that Microsoft has provided will already be translated for you. The tables that Andrew made, on the other hand, will have to be custom translated. So how do we do that next step? How do we translate our own tables?
Exactly. So we've already gone ahead and built this application. So how are we going to go about translating what we've already written in English? I'm going to come right back over to my solution here. We're going to back out just so I can see the whole thing real quick. And right over here in our three little dots, you can see at the bottom, there is an option for translations. Here I can either import or export. If I export them,
now, this is going to export an XML file that has every object that Andrew created in his application. So things like our labels, our choices and drop-down boxes. What it does not do is capture the data itself. So any kind of rows inside your data will not be translated. That's going to be just the labels in this case. So let's go ahead and open that up. Let's see what we got
here. So our zip file has gone ahead and downloaded. We're going to open that up. So first thing that you want to do is go ahead and extract these. I've already got a folder open. You can go ahead and make whichever one you want, extract it anywhere you want. We're just going to get it out of this zip file real quick. So I've gone ahead and made a folder for my translations.
Okay. Now we want to use, there's a lot of editors we can use to edit that XML file. My favorite way of doing it probably is going to be Excel in this case.
All right, so we're going to go ahead and go into our Excel and we're going to open what we just got. So I'm going to go and browse. I'm going to go to downloads, translations. And then you're going to want this file right here that's crmtranslations.xml. And you'll notice right down here, we've got three different sections. Right here's just general information about our translations. If we come over to display strings, these are all the sort of standard settings that Microsoft already provides you with. So as you can see, up here in this column where it says 1033, that was the 4-digit code for English. So it's got, if I expand it, all the different English options that are in there, and then right next to them, 3082 is the code for Spanish.
So Microsoft's already done that for us.
Yeah, that's already set up.
How about your stuff?
Right, so if we come over to this little tab right here in the bottom left, localized labels, it's gonna be all the stuff that we have in our solution. Now, if you notice, it's pretty much not translated yet. So this is gonna require you to have some base language, some base knowledge of the language.
Google Translate, maybe?
Or Google Translate, yeah. Google Translate. So we're gonna go ahead and let's see. I'll just make some very quick ones, like here in status, we'll go estado active, you know, activo. I'm trying to aim for all the things that aren't gonna use accents.
And you can see where it's coming from. Like there's a display label of a certain field, the active field, and it has on the far left the table it's going to be part of also. So all those pieces are all in there. Table name first with your logical name, the GUID of that, and then the display label there also. So that's how you can kind of track that down. Right. That's good enough. We can save it then, and we can then...
Yeah. So I've made a couple of translations here, and this could be changed, exported, imported, however many times you'd like. I'm just going to go ahead and let's go ahead and save this and close it out. There we go. I'm going to save this, close it out, and then I'm going to go ahead and compress it one more time. Compress to zip file.
All right, cool.
All right, so we've gone ahead and compressed it. Now we're going to go back into our solutions and we're going to go find our Potter's House treasure system. And just like we exported it back to us, we're going to go ahead to translations and import our translations. Right, so we'll choose a file. We'll find the...
Under downloads, yeah.
Here we go.
Translate.
Find the new one that we just made. Here it says content types. It just picked a name for me. I'm gonna go ahead and open that, and that'll import it into our solution.
It looks to be done now, so we can hit done and then publish our customizations in. But like you said, if I open this app up on a Windows device or a Mac device that has a regional language of Spanish now, it will automatically do that now for those elements that you just did.
Yes.
So let's go ahead and open up a solution just to make sure and do a publish all customizations up top to make sure everything's all solid. Now the other thing is this is a quite different on the Canvas app, right? So on the Canvas app, it's much more about you as a developer doing this.
Yes.
Do you want to show that real quick, the Canvas app?
Yeah, we're going to show that. So we've got a Canvas app open, our attendance tracker right here. If you notice, I'm going to zoom in just in case. It's a little bit hard to see. But all of our options right now are in English. Well, we do have an OnStart property that is able to translate it for us instead. So the way we're going to do that, let me have my application selected. As you can see, I'm already in my OnStart property.
All right, so the application that Andrew just pulled up here in this case, is, as you can see, is all in English. Now, what we did to translate is a whole bunch of ways you can do this. What I chose to do in this case was put things into the OnStart property. So whenever the application opens up, it will create a collection of what we want those labels to look like. Do we want them to say the Spanish word or English word? It's all based on a function that will run as soon as you kick in also. Andrew, let's open up the OnStart property.
Yeah. So we're gonna go ahead and select app in our tree view here. And our OnStart property is already selected from our property dropdown. Get out of the way right there.
Okay.
Let me open it up.
Sounds good. And if you would zoom in there. As you can see here, we're basically starting with localizing a variable here saying var language. Var language is what language are you speaking? And the language function is going to read that is either English US or ES for Spanish in this case. Then we create a collection, which is basically a table in memory. You can also import data from things like Excel if you wanted to or whatnot. Well, I chose to do it more in a collection because I thought it'd be speedier in that case. So you can see each property here has a label and it has the English variant and the Spanish variant. So just for giggles here, if he changes his hard codes, his language right there to ES versus ENUS right there, and then runs the OnStart, there we go.
There we
Watch
go.
What happens when he runs that app OnStart now. And then let's go ahead and show the labels in the background now. So you'll see in this case that what's happening, if you look at any of those labels, header, whatever there, let's look at that button, for example, the listo button.
Listo.
All right, which means save or ready or whatever. You'll see if you look at the label itself, the text label, just click on that little text label right there or go to the, oh, that'll work also. So you'll see it basically doing a lookup against that local collection, and it's saying I'm passing a label in of what my label is, and then I'm getting back the language in that case. Again, there's tons of ways of doing this. This is just a way I thought to rapidly create this as fast as possible. So we showed you two ways now. Now, ideally, if we go back to the application, that model-driven application, and you redo a hard refresh here, the publication should be done. Now, we're still going to get English because this PC is in English right now. But we'll start to see if we were on a Spanish machine right now. It looks no different to us as an English machine, but if we were on a Spanish machine or an Arabic machine, we start to see those labels now in Arabic or Spanish or whatever our current language was. Again, the only difference is the actual data will still be in whatever language the data entry person was in.
Right.
All right, thanks for watching this video on how to translate your application into multiple languages. This also works in Power Pages, and if you are interested in this type of stuff, please do let us know in the comments, what would you like to see as far as translations go? How would you like to see it advance even to make it even easier for you, and if it's even important to you? Thanks so much. Have a great day.